Hello, fellow Minecrafters. I'm Cake. That was a sheep. And we are playing Minecraft. I'm going to show you a way to turn lava into obsidian, mostly for large structures, much, much faster than either a traditional mold, or laying it down and then using a diamond pick to get it up. You might think of the diamond pick thing as the, newer player or noob method, the mold as a experienced player or pro tip, and this is a super pro tip. This is a I stay up and play Minecraft too damn much tip. Alright. So you can see I'm neither on fire nor is there a sign of cobblestone anywhere. This is because, while people seem to think that flowing water flowing into still lava will turn to obsidian, this is not the case. From what I can gather, obsidian actually checks if there's any sort of water to the sides of it or above it, and if there is, it will turn itself into obsidian. Now the coding might work differently, but essentially that's how it is. If the water's below it, it will actually destroy it and create flowing lava there. Flowing lava will destroy a block below it, unless there are also blocks to the side of it, and that's why you get the nice little cobblestone catcher's mitt type of thing when lava flows into a big pool of water, instead of the lava just spreading out almost infinitely. It's very important while you're doing this to remember to hold down the jump button. The reason for that is, I'll stop jumping for a sec. It is safe to do this once. I would not want to do this more than once, because if you do it twice in a row, your head is encased in obsidian. You know what, I'll do it twice in a row. I want to show you guys what'll happen. And if I die, I can just run around here collecting my buckets and we'll call it the end of the video. You do it once without jumping. You're up to your knees. I always forget how to do the third person. Alright. You're up to your knees. Oh, you're up past your knees in obsidian. You do it twice. You're completely encased in obsidian. And you can still jump out of it. Unless you happen to be right under your mold up there, and that'll also stop you from jumping. I guess the point I'm trying to make is, watch where the heck your endpoint is, and stop a little bit ahead of time. As you can see, though, without the pointless chattering and encasing myself in obsidian, this is a lot quicker than building a mold. Essentially, it's building one mold as high up as you want your structure to be, and then just making a waterfall go down at a time. You don't have to do it again. And once you're done, you can just demolish your scaffolding. I'm not going to demolish my scaffolding just because it's going to be behind the walls of my tower. It's going to have ladders. I'll make it really convenient to go behind and do redstone work. I'm actually going to take signs and label up how high it is inside, because say I want a button. Say I want a button. God damn it, I wish I had a bone arrow. I hate cows. Say I want a button here. I don't want to pick through that to make a button. I want to be able to look at how high up it is here, look at the sign on this side, slap down the redstone, not have to worry about it. Now, as far as other things go, my obsidian does not want to pour anymore. I'm not that high up yet. Is it my mouse? Oh, there we go. It was my mouse. I must be running out of batteries. As you can see, I'm getting perilously close to the top of this. What I'm gonna do is... I'm gonna jump over, swim up. This actually serves as a great way up and down while you're working. Though I did make a ladder, so the ascent is a little bit quicker. This is really only for the last 4 or 5 squares. Unless you want to waste a lot of time swimming up and down. Alright. Well, I guess that's about it. I am gonna kill some farm animals. And, my next Let's Play, if anyone wants to see it, is going to be me making a day-night clock that will automatically reset itself, even if you leave the chunk and come back. The problem with most clocks made out of redstone is that if you go too far away, they'll just stop working. Or if you come back and they're working, it'll be the wrong time because they won't have been loading or doing anything in your absence. So I'm going to make a day-night clock that'll automatically reset itself, and I'm going to put that in a lot of external lighting. Maybe a little redstone torch near the exits that'll tell you if it's daytime or nighttime outside, stuff like that. It should be fun, so let me know if you have any interest in seeing that. This is Cake, and I hope you all have a great day. Now I think we should go out with a bang.